हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज असरा सुल्ताना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ट्रिपल डिपार्टमेंट वर्किंग इन आईएसएल इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज। आई एम टेकिंग द सब्जेक्ट इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन्स वन फॉर ट्रिपल सेकेंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स। लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फोर्स एज ए पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव ऑफ स्टोर्ड एनर्जी विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू पोजिशन ऑफ ए मूविंग एलिमेंट। सो वी हैव सीन बोथ थियोरी एंड न्यूमेरिकल्स बेस्ड ऑन दिस टॉपिक। टूडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू सी torque as a partial derivative of stored energy with respect to angular position of rotating element. So this is also called as the title of this can be also called as multiply excited magnetic field systems. So let us see what we have seen in the previous class. Force as a partial derivative of stored energy with respect to position of a moving element, we have seen it. So under this we have seen, so this was the linear case. Okay, today we are going to see about the multiply excited magnetic field system. So earlier the system was excited with only one exciting device. Okay, now when we have to derive the torque as a partial derivative, so at the time we have to study the multiply excited magnetic field system. So this topic, force as a partial derivative of stored energy with respect to position of a moving element, there we have seen. The equations we got for Wf dash, that is for co-energy and energy Wf. Okay, Wf was integral 0 to b h dB or half b square by mu, and Wf dash was half mu h square or half b square by mu. So for linear case, field energy will be equal to co-energy. These are the key points of what we have studied. Okay, so electromechanical energy conversion devices will be built with air gaps in the magnetic circuits, which will serve to separate the stationary and moving numbers. So I lambda relationship of magnetic circuit will almost be linear. So assuming linearity, Wf is half I lambda, that is half R phi square, and Wf will become half lambda square by L if you substitute I equal to lambda by L. So Wf is a function of lambda x, that is equal to half lambda square by L of x. Or Wf can be written as Wf by AL. A is the area and L is the length of the field. And Wf is equal to half B square by mu. And for linear case, field energy is equal to co-energy. H is magnetic field intensity, B is magnetic flux density. And Wf dash is integral 0 to I. Lambda is equal to Li dI, that is half Li square. Or Wf dash, if it is a function of Ix, then it is equal to half L of x I square. Wf dash is equal to half mu h square or half b square by mu. Then field energy and mechanical force we have seen. So we have considered an attracted armature relay excited by an electric source. Field produces a mechanical force Ff in the direction which is indicated, which drives the mechanical system, and mechanical work done by field when the armature moves the distance dx in positive direction is given as dWm is equal to Ff dx. So mechanical, according to principle of energy conservation, mechanical energy output is equal to electrical energy input minus increase in field energy. So same thing in symbolic form we are writing as Ff dx is I d lambda minus dWf. So we know the value of Wf. Wf is I lambda minus Wf dash I, function of Ix. So dWf will be I d lambda when you take the derivative of uv, u differential v plus v differential u. We will get dWf as id lambda plus lambda di minus dou Wf dash by dou I di plus dou Wf dash by dou x dx. So finally we are going to get the value of Ff as dou Wf dash by dou x as a function of Ix. So this is the expression for mechanical force developed, and it applies when I is an independent variable, that is it is a current excited system. So for current excited system, Ff is dou Wf dash by dou x function of Ix. So now let us consider variables as lambda x. Variables as lambda x, then what? Same, we have to follow the earlier steps and deriving the equation for Ff. Ff is equal to minus dou Wf by dou x function of lambda x. Direction of mechanical force developed. Ff is positive, that is it acts in positive difference direction of x. If dou Wf by dou x as a function of lambda x is negative, which means that stored energy of field is reduced with increase of x, while flux linkages are held fixed. So in the figure we can see as x increases, that is armature moves towards left, then field energy for fixed lambda is reduced because the air gap is reduced. So it means that FF in this case acts in the positive direction. So therefore it can be concluded that mechanical force produced by the field acts in a direction to reduce field energy, or in other words, the system seeks a position of minimum field energy and maximum co-energy. So determination of mechanical force for non-linear case we can see. So mechanical force is given by partial derivative of co-energy and energy. So in non-linear case, derivative must be determined numerically or graphically by assuming a small increment delta x. So FF is nearly equal to delta f dash by delta x, I is constant, and FF is equal to minus delta f by delta x, lambda is equal to constant. It was for non-linear case. Let us see for linear case. Linear case, we can write FF is minus dou wf by dou x, that is half lambda by L of x square into dou L of x by dou x. So, FF is equal to minus dou wf by dou x, that is minus half y square dou r of x by dou f. FF of lambda x is half lambda A of x, and FF is equal to minus dou wf by dou x, that is minus half lambda dou I of x by dou x. Mechanical energy. When armature is allowed to move from position xA to xB with the current coil remaining constant at I naught, then mechanical energy output is delta WM is integral xA to xB FF dx. So these are the diagrams for non-linear and linear cases. For non-linear case, we will get a curve. For linear case, we will get a straight line. Then we have seen numericals. Okay, based on the topics, we have seen the numericals. If you have any doubts, you ask your students in the numericals or in the theory part. Then core with air gap we have seen. Transformers will be wound on closed cores. Rotating machines will have moving element and must therefore have air gaps in the core. Typical magnetic circuit with air gap is shown in the figure. And its equivalent circuit is also shown. So here we are assuming that air gap is narrow and flux coming out of the core will pass straight down the air gap, such that the flux density in the air gap is same as in the core. So as will soon be seen, the flux in the gap fringes out so that the gap flux density is somewhat less than that of the core. So let core permeability mu c be regarded as constant. That is, we are assuming that linear magnetization characteristics. Ni will be equal to Hc Lc plus Hg Lg, or Ni equal to Bc by mu c Lc plus Bg by mu naught Lg. So we are assuming that core flux passes straight down the air gap, that is no fringing, then Bg is equal to Bc and phi equal to Bca and phi equal to Bga. So after substitutions and all, we are going to get the value of phi. Okay, so we are going to get the value of phi as MMF by Rg. Rg because here Rg is nothing but reluctance of air gap. Rc is the reluctance of core. Okay. So Rc is not included here because Rc is very very less than Rg, so it can be neglected. So phi is equal to MMF by Rg only, reluctance of air gap. Leakage flux, very very important for 2 marks. In all practical magnetic circuits, most of the flux is confined to the intended path by use of magnetic cores, but a small amount of flux always will leak through the surrounding air. This flux is called as leakage flux. Okay, some amount of flux will be leaking out of the core, or not all the flux is confined to the core. So that is called as leakage flux. Next is the topic fringing. So for 2 marks, if you get what is fringing, then you have to draw this diagram, write this entire theory. So at an air gap in a magnetic core, flux fringes out into neighboring air paths. Okay, so this is also same like that, but here it is fringing out into neighboring air paths. So these being of reluctance comparable to that of gap, result is a non-uniform flux density in the air gap, enlargement of the effective air gap area and a decrease in average gap flux density. Effect of fringing will increase with air gap length, and now air gap reluctance Rg is equal to Lg by mu naught Ag. So how we can correct fringing? Fringing can be corrected by adding one gap length to each one of the two dimensions, making up its area. So this we have seen in numericals also. Okay, how to correct the fringing? So numericals in detail already has said in the previous classes. So please follow that, all of you. Okay. All these numericals were very very important. For long questions, you may get this LAQ. So let us start with this topic. Torque as a partial derivative of stored energy with respect to angular position of rotating element. See, linear position we will get force. Okay, angular position we will get torque. So this topic is important. Both theory and problems are important for long answers. See now, long answers you can expect 15 marks because new question paper pattern. According to new question paper pattern, you are getting a long answer for 15 marks. Previously, you used to get a long question for 10 marks. So under that, A bit B bit means 5 5. It is divided into 5 and 5. But now if you get A and B bit for 15 marks question, it is divided as 7.5 and 7.5. Okay, or 8 and 7. So according to your marks, you have to write the answer in the exam. Okay, students. So let us start the topic. Singly excited devices are generally employed for motion through a limited distance or rotation through a prescribed angle. Electromechanical transducers have the special requirement of producing electrical signal proportional to forces or velocities, or producing force proportional to electrical signal. So what we are telling here, that usually singly excited. So earlier we have seen that only one excitation was there. Only this side only we were applying voltage. But in multiply excited, we are having one more excitation. Two excitations are there, multiply excited. So singly excited was generally employed for motion through a limited distance or rotation through a prescribed angle. So they are used, singly excited are used only for motion through a limited distance or rotation through a prescribed angle only. But electromechanical transducers have a special requirement of producing electrical signal which is proportional to force or velocity, or it will produce force proportional to electrical signal. It can be current or voltage. Such transducers will require two excitation. One excitation establishes a magnetic field of specified strength, while other excitation will produce desired signal. It can be electrical or mechanical. So yeah, this multiply excited system is used, mostly used in transducers, where first excitation will establish a magnetic field of specified strength. Okay, so one coil we are exciting to create the magnetic field, other coil we are exciting to produce the desired signal. It can be electrical or mechanical. So also continuous energy conversion devices like motors and generators require multiple excitation. So generators and motors also require multiple excitation. So this is the figure showing a magnetic field system with two electrical excitations. One is on stator side, another is on rotor side. Okay, stator means what? Stationary part. Rotor is a rotating part. So one winding is wound on stator, another winding is wound on rotor. System can be described in either of the two sets of the three independent variables. So we can describe the system in three independent variables, that is lambda 1, lambda 2, theta. Or I1, I2, theta. So earlier in linear case, what we have seen with respect to two things, that is Ix and with respect to lambda x. Now we have to see here now lambda 1, lambda 2, theta, I1, I2, theta. Okay. So in terms of first set, Tf is equal to minus dot Wf by dot theta. And it is a function of lambda 1, lambda 2, theta. So first we are considering lambda 1, lambda 2, theta. Next we will consider I1, I2, theta as in the case for linear case. Okay. Now here field energy is given as Wf, function of lambda 1, lambda 2, theta is equal to integral 0 to lambda 1, I1 d lambda 1 plus integral 0 to lambda 2, I2 d lambda 2. Where I1 is dou Wf by dou lambda 1 as a function of lambda 1, lambda 2, theta. I2 is equal to dou Wf by dou lambda 2. It is a function of lambda 1, lambda 2 and theta. So we are assuming linearity here. So lambda 1 will be equal to L11 I1 plus L12 I2 and lambda 2 is L21 I1 plus L22 I2 into where L12 is equal to L21. So I1 is equal to beta 11 lambda 1 plus beta 12 lambda 2. I2 is equal to beta 21 lambda 1 plus beta 22 lambda 2 where beta 21 is beta 12. So, solving for I1 and I2 in terms of lambda 1 and lambda 2 and substitute in equation 2, we will get upon integration Wf is equal to Wf as a function of lambda 1, lambda 2, theta is equal to integral 0 to lambda 1, beta 11 lambda 1 plus beta 12 lambda 2 d lambda 1 plus integral 0 to lambda 2 beta 12 lambda 1 plus beta 22 lambda 2 d lambda 2. So, take out the constants, integrate the equation. Integral of uv is u integral v. No, you are not integral of uv here. Just we are taking out the constants and integral of lambda 1 is lambda 1 square by 2. Okay, then substituting the limit from 0 to lambda 2 and so on. So, Wf is equal to half beta 11 lambda 1 square plus beta 12 lambda 1 lambda 2 plus half beta 22 lambda 2 square. Where beta 11 is L22 by L11 L22 minus L12 square. Beta 22 is L11 by L11 L22 minus L12 square. And beta 12 is beta 21 that is minus L12 by L11 L22 minus L12 square. Self and mutual inductance of the two exciting coils will be function of angle theta. If currents are used to describe the system state, then Tf is equal to dou Wf dash by dou theta as a function of I1, I2, theta. Okay. So, till here we have completed for first part, that is Tf is equal to minus dou Wf by dou theta function of lambda 1, lambda 2, theta. Now, we are taking into consideration other variables, that is I1, I2, theta. So, now Tf will become equal to dou Wf dash by dou theta function of I1, I2, theta. Where co-energy is given as F dash, Wf dash means co-energy, only Wf is energy. So, Wf dash function of I1, I2, theta is equal to integral 0 to I1, lambda 1, di1 plus integral 0 to I2, lambda 2, di2. In the linear case, Wf dash function of I1, I2, theta is half L11, I1 square plus L12, I1, I2 plus half L22, I2 square. Where inductances are functions of angle theta. So, I hope this derivation is clear to everyone. So, what we have seen here, we have considered a multiply excited system, okay, and deriving the torque as a partial derivative of stored energy with respect to angular position of rotating element. So, singly excited are employed for motion through a limited distance or rotation through a prescribed angle, but a multiply excited system like a transducer will require two excitation. One excitation is to establish the magnetic field of specified strength, while the other excitation will produce a desired signal. It can be electrical or mechanical. Some motors and generators also require multiple excitation. Now this figure is showing a magnetic field system with two electrical excitation, one on stator, another on rotor. System can be described as either of the two sets of three independent variables, lambda 1, lambda 2, theta or I1, I2, theta. Then Tf is equal to minus dou Wf by dou theta function of lambda 1, lambda 2, theta. So, we are getting the equation for Wf as half beta 11, lambda 1 square plus beta 12, lambda 1, lambda 2 plus half beta 22, lambda 2 square. The next we considered Tf is equal to minus dou Wf dash by dou theta function of I1, I2, theta. Then we are getting Wf dash function of I1, I2, theta is half L11, I1 square plus L12, I1, I2 plus half L22, I2 square. Okay, student. Let us see the numericals. First one, the various inductances are L11 is 4 plus cos 2 theta into 10 power minus 3 Henry. L12 is 0.15 cos theta Henry. And L22 is 20 plus 5 cos 2 theta Henry. Find torque developed if I1 is equal to 1 amps, I2 equal to 0.02 amps. Let us see the solution. W of dash is equal to, as a function of I1 I2 theta, it is equal to half L11 I1 square plus L12 I1 I2 plus half L22 I2 square. So we have derived this equation just now. Okay. So substitute all the values. L11 is equal to 4 plus cos 2 theta into 10 power minus 3. I1 is 1. So 1 into 1 square plus L12 is 0.15 cos theta into I2 square. I2 is 0.02. Plus half L22 is 20 plus 5 cos theta into I2 square. I2 is 0.02 square. So when we do the substitution, we are going to get the value of TF is minus dou WF dash by dou theta, that is minus sin 2 theta into 10 power minus 3 minus 0.15 sin theta into 0.02 minus 5 sin 2 theta into 0.02 square. That is equal to minus 10 power minus 3 sin 2 theta minus 3 into 10 power minus 3 sin theta. All of you make a note of these problems. This kind of problem is very, very important. Previous CS papers, this is asked many times. Similar problem, okay? Two coupled coils have self and mutual inductance of L11 is 2 plus 1 by 2x, L22 is 1 plus 1 by 2x, L12 is equal to L21 is 1 by 2x. Over a certain range of linear displacement x, the first coil is excited by a constant current of 20 amps and second by a constant current of minus 10 amps. Find a bit mechanical work done if x changes from 0.5 to 1 meter. Second one, energy supplied by each electrical source in part A. Third one is change in field energy in part A. Hence, verify that the energy supplied by the sources is equal to increase in field energy plus the mechanical work done. So let us see the solution of this numerical. WF dash function of I1 I2 x is equal to half L11 I1 square plus L12 I1 I2 plus half L22 I2 square. So substitute all the values in given in the question. We are going to get the value of WF dash is 450 plus 25 by x. First bit we have to calculate mechanical work done. That FF is equal to dot WF dash by dot x, that is minus 25 by x square. Delta WM is integral 0.5 to 1 FF dx, that is integral 0.5 to 1 minus 25 by x square dx, that is minus 25 joules. B bit, delta WE1 is integral lambda 1 x is equal to 0.5 to x is equal to 1. I1 d lambda 1 is I1. At lambda 1 x minus 1, lambda is lambda 1 at x is equal to 1 minus lambda 1 at x is equal to 0.5. So lambda 1 is L11 I1 plus L12 I2. Substitute all the values. So lambda 1 at x is equal to 0.5 is 50 and lambda 1 at x is equal to 1 is 45. So delta WE1 will become equal to 20 into 45 minus 50, that is minus 100 joules. So delta WE we have found out. Now similarly find out delta WE2. Delta WE2 will be I2 into lambda 2 at x is equal to 1. Minus lambda 2 at x is equal to 0.5. Lambda 2 is equal to L12 I1 plus L22 I2. Substitute values of L12, L22, I1 and I2. So lambda 2 is minus 10 plus 5x. So lambda 2 at x is equal to 0.5 is 0 and lambda 2 at x is equal to 1 is minus 5. So delta WE2 is minus 10 into minus 5, that is 50 joules. Net electrical energy input delta WE is equal to delta WE1 plus delta WE2, that is minus 100 plus 50, that is minus 50 joules. See bit, for calculating the change in field energy, betas have to be obtained. So beta 11 is L22 by D. D is nothing but L11 L22 minus L12 square. That is 2x plus 1 by 4x plus 3. Beta 22 is 4x plus 1 by 4x plus 3. Beta 12 is minus 1 by 4x plus 3. At x is equal to 0.5, beta 11 is 2 by 5. Beta 22 is 3 by 5. Beta 12 is minus 1 by 5. At x is equal to 1, beta 11 is 3 by 7, beta 22 is 5 by 7 and beta 12 is 1 by 7. Field energy is given by WF is half beta 11 lambda 1 square plus beta 12 lambda 1 lambda 2 plus half beta 22 lambda 2 square. WF at x is equal to 0.5 is half into 2 by 5 into 50 square, that is 500 joules. And WF at x is equal to 1 is half into 3 by 7 into 45 square minus 1 by 7 into 45 into minus 5 plus half into 5 by 7 into minus 5 square, that is 475 joules. Delta WF is delta WF at x is equal to 1 minus WF at x is equal to 0.5. 475 minus 500, that is minus 25 joules. Delta WF plus delta WM is 20, minus 25 minus 25 minus 50. that is delta W E. Okay, so same V watt. Delta W E minus 50 V watt. So it is verified. In linear case with constant current excitation, delta WF is delta WF dash, and WF dash is 450 plus 25 by X. Delta WF dash is delta WF dash at X is equal to 1 minus WF dash at X is equal to 0.5. 475 minus 500, that is minus 25 joules. Next numerical. Two coupled coils have self and mutual inductances. L11 is 2 plus 1 by 2x, L22 is 1 plus 1 by 2x, L12 is equal to L21 is equal to 1 by 2x. Find the expression for time average force of field origin at x equal to 0.5 m. If A bit, both coils are connected in parallel across a voltage source of 100 cos 314 t. B bit, both coils are connected in series across a voltage source of 100 cos 314 t. C bit, coil 2 is shorted and coil 1 is connected to a voltage source of 100 cos 314 TV. And D bit, both coils are connected in series and carry a current of 0.5 cos 314 amperes. Let us see the solution. WF dash as a function of I1 I2 X is equal to half L11 I1 square plus L12 I1 I2 plus half L22 I2 square. So that is equal to half into 2 plus 1 by 2 X into I1 square plus 1 plus 1 by 2x into I1 I2 plus half 1 by 2x I2 square. FF is equal to dot WF dash by dot x as a function of I1 I2x. That is equal to minus 1 by 4x square I1 square minus 1 by 2x square I1 I2 minus 1 by 4x square I2 square. So for x is equal to 0.5 meters, FF is equal to minus I1 square minus 2 I1 I2 minus I2 square. So therefore, the force will act in a direction to decrease the value of X. A bit, both coils connected in parallel across voltage source. L11 is 2 plus 1 by 2X at X is equal to 0.5. So substitute X is equal to 0.5 here, we will get the value as 3. L22 is 1 plus 1 by 2X at X is equal to 0.5, it is the value is 2. And L12 is L21, that is equal to 1 by 2X at X is equal to 0.5, it is equal to 1. V is equal to E1, that is d lambda 1 by dt, that is d by dt of lambda 1. Lambda 1 is nothing but L11 I1 plus L12 I2. That is equal to 3, because L11 is 3 V watt. So 3 into di1 by dt plus L12 is 1. So plus 1 into di2 by dt. That is equal to 100 cos 314 t, it is given. And V equal to E2, that is d lambda 2 by dt, that is d by dt of L21 I1 plus L22 I2, that is L21 is 1, so di1 by dt plus L22 is 2, so 2 into di2 by dt, that is 100 cos 314 t. So solving these two equations, we will get the value of di1 by dt as 20 cos 314 t, di2 by dt as 40 cos 314 t. Integrating the above equations to get the values of i1 and i2. So i1 is equal to 20 by 314 sine 314 t, and i2 is equal to 40 by 314 sine 314 t. Substituting I1 and I2 in FF equation, so FF is equal to minus 1 by 314 square into 20 square plus 2 into 20 into 40 plus 40 square into sine square 314 t, that is minus of 60 by 314 square sine square 314 t. But 1 by t integral 0 to t sine square omega t dt is 1 by 2. So FF average is equal to minus 1 by 2 60 by 314 whole square, that is 0.0183. Newtons. V bit, both coils are connected in series across voltage source. Now V will be equal to d lambda 1 by dt plus d lambda 2 by dt, that is 3 di1 by dt plus di2 by dt plus di1 by dt plus 2 di2 by dt. But for series connection I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I. So V will be equal to 7 di by dt, that is 100 cos 314 t. Integrating the equation, we will get the value of I is equal to 100 by 7 into 314 sin 314 t. So substitute this value in FF. FF is equal to minus 4 into 100 by 7 into 314 square sin square omega t. Or FF average is equal to minus 2 into 100 by 7 into 314 square, that is equal to minus 0.00144 newtons. Now we will see the third bit, that is coil 2 shorted, coil 1 connected to voltage source. So 100 cos 314 t will be equal to 3 di1 by dt plus di2 by dt. This 0 equal to di1 by dt plus 2 di2 by dt. Solving this equation, we will get the value of di1 and di2, di1 by dt and di2 by dt. So di1 by dt is equal to 40 cos 314 t and di2 by dt is minus 20 cos 314 t. So integrating these equations to get the values of i1 and i2. So i1 is becoming now 40 by 314 into sin 314 t and i2 is minus 20 by 314 sin 314 t. Substitute I1 and I2 values in FF. So FF is equal to minus 1 by 314 square into 40 square minus 2 into 40 into 20 plus 20 square sin square 314 t. FF average is equal to minus half 20 by 314 square, that is minus 0.0203 newtons. D bit, both coils in series carrying current I equal to 0.5 cos 314 t. Substitute this value in FF. FF is equal to minus of 1 plus 2 in plus 1 into 0.5 square into cos square 314 t. FF average is minus 0.5 newtons. Thank you everyone for watching the video. I hope today's class is clear to everyone. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Students, you write the equation. Or send me to my WhatsApp number. You write in one paper and scan and send me, students, this derivation for multiply excited magnetic field system. So the entire derivation you send me. Okay. So this will be our work for today, and give the attendance in comment section. So all of you should send me a scanned copy of derivation of this multiply excited system. Okay. Thank you everyone for watching the video. Do watch the video from start till the end. Thank you.